Yo, Adam Saxon with Guy in the Cube, and in this video, I'm going to show you some different ways that you can modify your column headers, but more importantly, a trick to give your users a little hint. Let's do this. If you're finding us for the first time, be sure to hit that subscribe button to stay up to date with all the videos from both Patrick and myself. All right, column headers. You may be like, I know how to do this, Adam. Why are you talking about this? Some people don't, so I just want to cover it, but this is going to be a quick video, so enough all this talking. Let's head over to my machine and see what this is all about. All right, let's cover the basics first. Let's start with Power Query, because that's how we're going to pull data into Power BI. So you may know that you can rename column names inside of Power Query itself. So when you're working with that data, we could just come in and double click on a column name, change it to whatever we want. And there's lots of different ways you can do that. You can double click on it. You can right click and say rename down on the bottom there. And that's going to pull that into the actual data model itself. That's number one. Number two is you could actually come in to the, say, customer. We can change name here right in the model view. So this is actually editing the model directly. This is another option that you have in your tool belt, right? So maybe you haven't explored this all the way, but you can go through and actually do a lot of things here, including descriptions for, like, when you hover over the item, it'll tell you that information. So that might be neat for you. Another thing you have is your measures themselves, right? So when you're creating your measures, so like total sales amount, you can actually modify that name of that measure to be whatever you want, right? So make it meaningful, make it something that users are going to understand, but you can make it what you want in order to get the impact that you want for that item. All right, so let me go into what actually drove this video. I was talking to someone when we were going through the log analytics piece and the report that comes with log analytics. When we were exploring that a little bit, they were like, whoa, wait, that column name, how did you do that? And I was like, wait, what? It didn't even dawn on me, but they pointed it out and I'm like, oh, wow, let me show you how to do that. Let me show you what they were talking about. This is the analytics report for the AS trace information for the log analytics. If you haven't seen that, go check out the video I did on that where I walked through this whole thing. Under the engine activities though, in a matrix, there was a column header here that actually showed like a hierarchy of what was underneath. And so you could actually see that the first level's capacity, then workspace, then data set, and then report. They're like, how did you do that? Let me actually show you this trick. And this can really help with your users if they don't know like what the levels are that are apparent here. They don't know what those items are. Because if you just saw by default, it'd be capacity. And we're like, okay, well, I don't know what to do with these. Let me jump over to my report. And you'll see that we can easily do this from an actual matrix or table or whatever we want. So let's just build a new one and we'll do this together. First, we're going to pull in the fields that we want. So we'll do values, we'll do total sales, we'll do total freight, and we'll do total quantity. Then what I'm going to do is I'm going to come to product and I want to say, bring the hierarchy in here. And this is what I'm talking about. By default, it just says category. And if I expand this, I mean, you can make an assumption here, right? These are all categorical items. That makes sense, but it's not as intuitive. Like, I don't necessarily know what those items are or what they relate to. Now, one thing I can't do here is modify anything here. So let me remove this. We'll come at it from another way. One thing I can do here is let me drag in category. Let me drag in subcategory. So basically, I'm ignoring the hierarchy right now and bring in product name and I get the same effect. But the difference here is I can double click on this item in the field well. So you can change the actual header of what's displayed here, the text, without actually modifying the fields in the field well, right? Because the fields themselves, we want to maintain that. We don't want to do this in a destructive way because other report users may use this for other purposes and we want to be flexible. But here I can actually do this specific to the visual. So I can just change that and then bam, look at that right there. It's bananas. So you can modify this and tweak this a little bit just for that visual and not affect the model. But wait, there's more. What if you wanted to do the category hierarchy here and have it reflect this information? Let's get rid of those. Bring that back in. Like I said before, I can't double click here. It's not something that I can do to rename it for the visual specifically. So in this case, you may think, oh, well, I can just rename the category hierarchy. But if I do that, it's not going to reflect that in the column header. It's going to pick whatever the first item is in that hierarchy. So what you'd have to do is actually rename it here. In this case, I am being a little destructive from a name perspective, but within the hierarchy, that may be okay for your purposes unless you want that specific item. So be mindful about that. But when I drag that in, then I get that name that's available for me from a hierarchy perspective. Bam, that is just a trick and a tool in your tool belt that you can use to just help your report users to understand your reports better. I'd love to know your thoughts. Did you know about this? Is there maybe a different approach that you're taking with your reports and visuals that maybe I don't know about? Go ahead and share it down in the comments below. Let us know. Let's keep that conversation going. If you like this video, be sure to hit that big thumbs up button. Smash it if you so desire. If it's your first time here, hit that subscribe button. And as always, from both Patrick and myself, thank you so much for watching. Keep being awesome, and we'll see you in the next video.